Hello everyone, welcome to Apti Plus Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily news and editorial analysis, which I'll be covering from the Hindu and Indian Express. So the most important news and editorial would be discussed in this session. So before I start, just to tell you the today's topic list. Today is 29th of July. The first topic is Centre to roll out academic bank of credit. Second, Parliament passes bill amid continuing protest. We've seen that with regards to the Pegasus and farm law, which was passed by the parliament, the protest is ongoing in the recent monsoon session. Third, US Secretary of State to visit to India. Second last is from Indian Express, an editorial, making national education policy work. So we're discussing two editorial, and the other is from the Hindu, a judgment that must be taken in right spirit, right? So these are some of the important editorial and news from today's newspaper. Apart from that, there would be some MCQ questions. These questions would be based on current affairs that will help in the upcoming prelims examination. So without any further ado, let's get started. And those of you who are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe Apti Plus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. Now the first news of the day, that is Centre to roll out academic banks of credit. This is a decision which is something which would help the student, upcoming aspirants and all other students who are pursuing for an higher education, right? So this is important for your general studies paper 2, issues related to development and management of education as well as for the human resources. So what decision has been taken by the government? Oh, we are witnessing today the first anniversary of NEP, that is New Education Policy 2020. So today, same day last year, the new education policy was passed. So now Centre has officially, in this, to mark this first anniversary, Centre has come up with the academic banks of credit, right? We'll understand the detail about what is academic bank of credit, how this is going to function, but just understand the basics. Pathkaregar ABC, we call it ABC. So ABC shall be established on the line of National Academic Depository, which is already in India mein functional. Hai. ये स्टोर करेगी स्टूडेंट बेसिकली एनएडी की बात करें यहाँ पे एकेडमिक डॉक्यूमेंट्स आप स्टोर कर सकते हैं इन द वेबसाइट्स एंड देन द सेम पैरामीटर्स एबीसी इज गोइंग टू ऑपरेशनलाइज इसके जितने भी स्टेक होल्डर्स है जो फर्दर हायर एजुकेशन में जो स्टूडेंट परस्यू करना चाहते हैं उनके डेटाज उनके क्रेडिट्स को यहाँ पे स्टोर किया जाएगा राइट नाउ व्हाट इज द एम ऑफ एकेडमिक बैंक क्रेडिट व्हाट वाज द रैशनल व्हाट गवर्नमेंट थॉट बिफोर कमिंग विद द बैंक सो एकेडमिक बैंक ऑफ क्रेडिट की अगर बात करें दिस इज अ नेशनल लेवल फैसिलिटी टू प्रमोट फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ऑफ करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क जो हर एक कॉलेजेस में एक करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क है एक इंटर डिसिप्लिनरी और मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी एकेडमिक मोबिलिटी है स्टूडेंट को वो प्रोवाइड की जाएगी ताकि वो अपने हायर एजुकेशन कंट्री अक्रॉस कंट्री कहीं भी ले सके राइट इफ यू आर स्विचिंग टू अनदर कॉलेजेस बाय परसुइंग वन ईयर डिग्री एंड मूविंग टू अनदर कॉलेज द सेकेंड ईयर योर क्रेडिट वुड बी टेकन इन टू द कंसिडरेशन राइट तो जो भी आपने क्रेडिट उस कॉलेज में इकट्ठे किए होंगे वट एवर क्रेडिट यू हैव एक्यूमुलेटेड वुड बी स्टोर्ड इन योर बैंक इन द क्रेडिट बैंक इन द एकेडमिक बैंक ऑफ द क्रेडिट्स नाउ द न्यू सिस्टम वुड अलाउ मल्टीपल एंट्री एंड एग्जिट ऑफ द हायर एजुकेशन यू कैन मूव फ्रॉम वन इंस्टीट्यूशन टू अनदर इंस्टीट्यूशन एज वेल एज इंजीनियरिंग प्रोग्राम इन द रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस गवर्नमेंट ने कहा है कि जो इंजीनियरिंग प्रोग्राम्स है उनको रीजनल लैंग्वेज में भी प्रमोट करने की कोशिश की जाएगी बट इट्स अ टफर टास्क रिजल्ट्स वुड बी गिवन सर्टिफिकेट्स वुड बी गिवन इन द रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस बट लेट्स सी हाउ दिस वुड बी एग्जीक्यूटेड नाउ क्या क्या बेनिफिट्स होंगे स्टूडेंट्स को इस तरह के बैंक से जो एकेडमिक बैंक ऑफ क्रेडिट बनाई गई है वी विल कॉल इट ऑन अ शॉर्टेड फॉर्म एबीसी सो एबीसी अकाउंट इट्स जस्ट लाइक अ क्रेडिट बैंक राइट दैट विल हैव अ रिपोजिटरी ऑफ स्टूडेंट एकेडमिक रिकॉर्ड्स एंड दैट विल बी कैलकुलेटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ क्लास वर्क ट्यूटोरियल्स दैट वुड बी स्टोर द असाइनमेंट दैट हैज बीन डन टू द स्टूडेंट वुड बी क्रेडिटेड नाउ यू हैव सीन फॉर द क्लास 12th एग्जामिनेशन जिस तरह से एग्जामिनेशन को कैंसिल की गई बिकॉज ऑफ द कोविड एंड व्हाट गवर्नमेंट डिड उनके असेसमेंट्स को क्लास 11th के यूनिट टेस्ट एंड अदर असेसमेंट प्रोग्राम वाज टेकन इनटू कंसीडरेशन फॉर द फाइनल इवैल्यूएशंस तो एक तरह से वो आप उसको एक माइन्यूट लेवल पे इफ यू वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड सो दैट कैन बी अ बैंक राइट जहां उनके क्रेडिट को रिपोजिट किया गया दे वर नो स्टोर्ड एंड फाइनली दे वर टेकन इनटू द कैलकुलेशंस राइट एक ब्रीफ आइडिया टू गेट अ बेसिक फॉर्म ऑफ हाउ द एकेडमिक बैंक ऑफ द क्रेडिट वुड वर्क Now, this will help the academic bank of the credit that student can avail multiple entry and exit options with the higher educations. Suppose a student is pursuing any degree from one particular institutions and he want to move out to the another college for the same degree or for any other branches that he is looking forward. So, uske credits ko wahan pe bhi utilize ki ja sakti, right? This is a tailor-made degree that can be availed from the students. Now, they can also choose to study one course in a year in one institution and switch to another course to another institution, right? As I've told you, this is a tailor-made and this would give more flexibility to the student to pursue their career from whichever institutions they want to continue with. Now, other important initiatives that would be launched to mark the first anniversary of new education policy. So, kuch initiatives launch kiye gaye hain, that is Vidya Pravesh. This is a 3-month play-based school preparation module for the student of class 1. Now, India has signed a language subject for the secondary level, NISTA 2.0, an integrated program for teacher training. This is designed by the NCERT. Factual question, important for the prelims examinations. Now, SAFL structures assessment for analyzing learning's level. A competency assessment based framework for class 3, 5 and 8 of the CBSE school students. A website would be dedicated for artificial intelligence. So these are some of the important initiatives like that would be launched today because we have this is the day where NEP was launched. So hopefully you'll get some more news tomorrow with regard to this. Now, pending reforms ki baat kare, jo government ne promise kiye the, usme Higher Education Commission for India ki baat ki gayi thi, HECI. So, this will offer a 4-year degree program and a Commerce University entrance examination would be there. This is not yet ready. So, let's see when government is coming up with this. Because of the COVID, the priority of the government has changed, right? We expect this to be coming from the next academic sessions. Already, agar aap baat kare, jitne bhi central universities hai, apart from India, basically kuch central universities jo nahi bane hai, usme 15 central universities around. So that central universities are having, they're conducting a common entrance examination, but jo Higher Education Commission for India ki baat ki gayi thi, that is not functional as of now. Now moving to the other news, that is Parliament passes bill amid continuing protest. This is important for your gender studies paper 2. So in paper 2, Parliament and state legislature functions, conduct of business and other privileges are issues arising from it. So what has happened? Like, we know that the monsoon session is ongoing and in this monsoon session, the two important issues, that is the Pegasus snooping and the other is the farm law. So these two are being, you know, argued from the oppositions and they're disrupting the house and not allowing the house to function. So both houses in the Parliament have cleared the bill, which was without debate, and because of the protest that is coming from the oppositions on the issues like Pegasus snooping and three contentions over the farm bill, which was passed by the Parliament, right? Farmers are also protesting in Delhi and other adjacent area. No, basically they're shifting to other states also like UP and Punjab. So they're protesting against this farm law. Now, the house was urgent several times before the legislative business which actually functions, or just as the house mein puri tarah se din thi, now it was being urgent for the day, and we're witnessing from the onset of the monsoon session the productivity is very less. Now, kon kon se aise bill hai jo kisme pass kiye gaye in this news, much important things are not there. But for you, it is very important that you have passed two important bills. I have discussed both of this bill before you. If you have seen our special series, PIB, even in the PRS and other stuffs, I have discussed this. So do check it out if you have not watched it. Because these two bills are very important, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Amendment Bill 2021. I have discussed this in detail. And the second is Juvenile Justice Protection Act Amendment Bill 2021. So this is the reason I'm considering this news to be important, because aapko ye dono jo bill hai unke important provisions janne zaruri hai. This can be an important question in the prelims examination, right? So the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code was passed in the Lok Sabha, and the Raj Sabha has passed the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Child Amendment Bill 2021, right? Now the other news, US Secretary of State visit to India. He has been continuously following this news. We have been following this news from the day Mr. Blinken was there. So now the final agreement has been reached out. We'll see what are the details coming from this. So this is effect of the policies and politics affecting what are the interests of India as a developing countries. So the US Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, is there on India, and he has made the External Affairs Minister. So this is the official visit, and both countries has discussed the cooperation of wide range of issues, right? That include Afghanistan, jo abhi stability ki baat ki ja rahi hai. NATO forces ne wahan se withdraw kiya, US forces ne withdraw kiya. Again, countering the COVID-19 situations for both countries, and Indo-Pacific strategy in the Quad. Quad is going to be one of the multilateral forum that would be very pivotal for the country like India. And even to counter the dominance of China, this forum is going to help a lot, right? The US Secretary of State ne kaha, he also met with the prime ministers, national security advisors. This is a routine protocol that every member who is visiting to a country, protocol hoti hai ki sare topmost unke leaders, bureaucrats se milna hota. And he has also met the representation with the Dalai Lama. If you talk about India and US relations, right? So the Prime Minister of India said that he welcomed the new president, the Joe Biden's strong commitment to strengthen India and US strategic partnership. Aur isme khas karke agar kuch important baat hogi ki jaye, so like they both country are looking forward for people to democracy, pluralism, rights, human rights issues and fundamental freedoms, right? The two sides also spoke about the Quad initiatives that will provide Indian made vaccines in the Indo-Pacific region. As you know, Remdesivir, when it was demanded, hydroxychloroquine, when it was demanded from the United States at the beginning of the virus, India has given a lot more drugs to United States. So US has announced 25 million grant to India for the vaccine program, and it has promised to strengthen the supply chain to enhance the productivity. Three important companies, Moderna, Pfizer, GlaxoSmith, Johnson & Johnson's, these are reputed companies that are operating with the vaccine in the United States. And as of now, in India has given Moderna and Pfizer approval. Let's see how this, when the vaccine is going to be started in India. Now talking about Afghanistan issues, yahan pe kuch important issues hai regarding Afghanistan. As I told you, the NATO forces is moving out, the US forces has moved out, and by September end, they have decided the deadline that they would be moving a lot more forces from there. So this was there in the agenda, that no military solution is an option in the Afghanistan. Peace, stability and a democratic setup would work for the Afghanistan. So in reference to the Pakistan, India has said that Afghanistan was not an exception, because certainly there would be influence of Pakistan that would be trying to counter and have the dominance in the region. And because of this, India is looking forward for a stability in the Afghanistan with the help of United States. So India would raise the need for sustained pressures on Pakistan or terror financing on the safe havens. Now, the other news, this is an editorial from Indian Express talking about making nations education policy work. NEP ke baare mein baat ki gayi hai. No, I've told you that today we're having the anniversary of national education policy. So this is again important for your general studies paper 2, issues related to development and management of educations and human resources. So what is there under these issues? So first we'll see the introductions, complex system and challenges, measures to implement the NEP 2020, and what would be the way forward, right? And if you talk about the theme of this editorial, pure editorial mein baat ki gayi hai ki kya kya challenges honge national education policy ko implement karne mein. So let's understand, in July 2020, last year, the government of India has launched new education policy 2020. और ये एक पाथ ब्रेकिंग इनिशिएटिव मानी गई थी टू री इमेजिन द फ्यूचर ऑफ एजुकेशन, वेयर दे वुड बी रिवैम्पिंग द एंटायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन द कंट्री. सो व्हाट वाज द एम ऑफ एनईपी 2020, अगर आपसे पूछा जाए, अगर ऐसे लिख रहे हैं, सो यू कैन राइट इंडिया एज अ ग्लोबल नॉलेज पावर, राइट, टू मेक इंडिया अ ग्लोबल नॉलेज सुपर पावर. And it proposed the revisions and revamping of all aspects of educational structures, including the regulation and governance. Jis tarah se India mein cheezon ko regulate ki jati hai, we have topmost body for medical educations, we have Medical Council of India. For primary and secondary educations, we have CBSC. For undergraduate and programs, we have UGC. So there would be a close coordination between all these autonomous, you know, all these institutions that are working under Government of India. Complex system and challenges ki baat ki gayi hai ki kaise system is getting complex. Since the year the announcement was made, jo focus hai, that was laid on the foundation of implementation. So yahan implementations mein kis tarah se challenges aayegi ek is policy ko implement karne mein, uske bare mein detail mein baatein hai. So before the work implemented, there is a strong need to understand ki policy kis karan se fail kar sakti hai and what we need to ensure so that this policy is implemented in a hassle-free manner. So the real challenge would be embedded in the complex system, NEP implementations ki baat kare. So these need a mindful of the challenge, we need to counter it, we need to counter it. And reacting to the policy, how it impact the implementation, your public policy hai that would have a empirical questions that the implementation has to be in a robust manner so that can help a lot for student study. Now, measures to implement the NEP, kya kya measures le jane ki zarurat hai taki jo new education policy hai, wo achi tarah se implement ho sake. So it is important to understand the challenges and it is necessary to work towards the model that reduce complexity. Jahan pe agar failure ki baat kare, jo possible success hai, that has to be achieved. And we know that in any implementation, there are some positive and some negatives, right? So definitely we have to see more on the possibility of success. And there's a need of institutional check and balances jahan pe har ek institutions ki responsibility set ki jayegi and this would be implemented under the new education policy. Now establishing the institutional mechanism jahan pe empowering steering committee banai ja sakti hai that would mandate the Ministry of Education's UGC ko jo center level pe regulatory bodies hain wo continuously in cheezon ko monitor kar sakte hain so that the implementation is done in a well fashion. Now, way forward ki agar baat kare, so the government need to provide a financial resources that are needed for the implementation of NEP. Not only the financial, but also the administrative experiences, the implementation of this program with all the stakeholders would be very important. And a special purpose vehicle, SPV ki zarurat padegi to create a fund for the national education policy, which would be implementing and delay is not required, right? So definitely jaldi se special purpose vehicle lane ki zarurat hai so that the implementation process can start. Because of the COVID-19, the overall implementation has already been delayed. So the vision of national education policy must be served by its implementation. Once it is implemented, then only we can say that yes, we are finally observing the all the features that were envisaged in the new education policy. If the implementation is not done, it will take another year or two to start with this visions of new education policy. Now celebrate with the time the history so far education transformation is concerned. We need to definitely transform it because the new education policy ki jo visions hai that aims to create a knowledge superpower India which would cater the global requirement of the world. Now the other editorial from the Hindu, a judgment that must be taken in the right spirit. So this is important for your general studies paper 2, structure, organization, function of executive and judiciary. So here the question is important both for the prelims as well as for the mains examination, right? Factual question and descriptive question can be important from this sections. So what is all about in this editorial? So editorial mein baat ki gayi hai 97th amendment ki jo violations hai, basic structure of constitutions ko violate karti hai. How we'll understand that verdict which was given by the Gujarat High Court, what is 97th Constitutional Amendment Act, observations by the court, amendment to the constitutions, how this is made, and a purpose for a cooperative sectors. Now Supreme Court ne recently upheld kiya ki jo 2013 ki judgment thi Gujarat High Court ki, which struck down the provisions of the Constitutional 97 Amendment Act. So Supreme Court ne kaha ki jo Gujarat High Court ki judgment thi wo se ittefaq rakhte hain, they upheld that and it extend that isme baat ki gayi thi extension of part jo part 9b hai usko lekar, right? And this talks about the cooperative society. Cooperative society is something which is very important for your mains examination. Even in the general studies paper 4, case studies mein bhi aapse sawal puche ja sakte hain. Now Gujarat High Court ne kya verdict di the jisko Supreme Court ne stand kiya, they have upheld that. So Gujarat High Court has categorically struck down the amendment in 2013 that बेसिकली गुजरात हाईकोर्ट ने कहा था इट्स फेल टू कंप्लाई विद द रिक्वायरमेंट्स अंडर आर्टिकल 368 सब क्लॉज 2 बाय द वर्च्यू दैट इट हैज नॉट गिवन रेक्टिफिकेशन बाय द स्टेट्स. सो स्टेट्स की जो स्टेक होती है किसी भी बिल को पास करने में व्हेन देयर इज अमेंडमेंट दैट इज बीइंग मेड, वहां पे स्टेट्स को इससे अछूता रखा गया. दे वर नॉट गिवन एडिक्वेट स्टेक ऑन द पासेज ऑफ दिस कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द 97th अमेंडमेंट, जो वायलेट करती है बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस को, उसके अमेंडमेंट को, राइट. सो द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट चैलेंज द गुजरात हाईकोर्ट जजमेंट बिफोर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, बट कोर्ट ने कहा था कि जिस तरह से 73rd और 74th अमेंडमेंट लाए गए हैं दैट इंट्रोड्यूस द चैप्टर ऑन पंचायत एंड म्यूनसिपैलिटी रिस्पेक्टिवली, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी कंसिडर स्टेट एज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड की प्लेयर इन ओवरऑल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, राइट. तो आपसे अगर पूछा जाए मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन में, देन यू कैन कोट दिस, एंड इफ यू आर रेड द बेसिक इंडियन पॉलिटी बाय लक्ष्मीकांत और एनी अदर बुक, मेक श्योर यू आर यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द 73rd एंड 74th अमेंडमेंट, इवन द पेसा एक्ट विच इज देयर, दीज बेसिक स्टैटिक पोर्शन शुड बी कंप्लीटेड. वॉट इज 97th कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट, अगर इसकी बात करें, दैट कम इन टू इफेक्ट ऑन फेब्रवरी 2012, और यहाँ पे कुछ चेंजेस लाई गई थी रिगार्डिंग द लीगल रिजीम ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज. तो 97th कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट में बताया गया कि इफेक्टिव मैनेजमेंट ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी इज वेरी एसेंशियल, एंड द एक्ट प्रोवाइडेड फॉर कोऑपरेटिव एंड इंसर्टेड आर्टिकल 43B इन द पार्ट 9B ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, राइट. जो अमेंडमेंट हुई थी उसमें कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज को एक इस तरह से बनाया गया टू प्रोटेक्ट द फॉर्म ऑफ एसोसिएटेड अंडर आर्टिकल 19(1)(c), दैट इज इवेल्टिंग द फंडामेंटल राइट्स. Now, it also inserted part 9b in the constitution, which laid down terms for the cooperative society, which would be governed. Now, what is the observation that was made by the court? So, abhi recent mein jo Supreme Court ke jo bench the, this was the observation which was made by the Supreme Court. So, the three-judge bench has said that the judgment given by the Gujarat High Court that have, no, the bench has dismissed the appeal. जो अपील फाइल की गई थी गुजरात हाईकोर्ट के जजमेंट को लेकर के, कोर्ट ने, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने इसको डिसमिस कर दिया, एंड दे सेड व्हाट एवर गुजरात हाईकोर्ट हैज सेड वी आर अपहेल्डिंग, एंड द बेंच हैज यूनानिमसली हैज डिसाइडेड दैट जो 97 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट रेक्टिफिकेशन है जिसमें वन हाफ ऑफ स्टेट की कंसिडरेशन होती है अंडर आर्टिकल 368 2. नाउ सिंस द अमेंडमेंट डील्स विद द एंट्री विच वॉज एन एक्सक्लूसिव सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द स्टेट, सो कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी की जो सोल प्रेरोगेटिव है वो स्टेट के पास होती है और सेंटर उसमें इंटरवीन करके अमेंडमेंट करके बहुत ज़्यादा चेंजेस नहीं कर सकती, ऐसा कहना है सुप्रीम कोर्ट का. नाउ अमेंडमेंट टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू मस्ट बी अवेयर हाउ डज नाउ अमेंडमेंट इज मेड इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. आर्टिकल 368 इज देयर, सो इट कैन बी अमेंडेड अंडर 368, और उसके कुछ कुछ प्रोसीजर्स हैं, वोटिंग्स राइट्स होते हैं अंडर स्पेशल सर्कमस्टांसेस में अमेंडमेंट कैन बी मेड, और कुछ ऐसे प्रोसीजर्स हैं जहाँ पे रेक्टिफिकेशन ऑफ स्टेट्स की ज़रूरत होती है जो कि 79th अमेंडमेंट में नहीं ली गई. दैट्स द रीज़न द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज़ आस्क्ड दैट वॉट एवर गुजरात हाई कोर्ट हैज़ गिवन द जजमेंट दैट इज ट्रू एंड वी वुड बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद दैट ओनली. नाउ पर्पस ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर्स की अगर बात करें, किस तरह से कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर्स फंक्शंस करती हैं, सो आइडिया जो है कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर्स का दैट इज द स्टेट लेवल एंड नॉट द सेंट्रल लेवल, राइट. यूनियन की यहाँ पे इन्वॉल्वमेंट काफ़ी कम होनी चाहिए. दिस इज ऑल्सो विच वॉज एनविसास्ड इन द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट 1990 विच कॉल्ड फॉर द कोऑपरेटिव इन द प्रोविंशियल लिस्ट, एंड दिस स्कीम कैरिड आउट विद फॉरवर्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस विद एंट्री 32 स्टेट लिस्ट में 7th शेड्यूल में. यूनियन 7th शेड्यूल देर आर 3 लिस्ट, one is center list, other is a state list, another is concurrent list. You can say by the center, I mean union list, which is mentioned in your book, union list, state list and concurrent list. So states ke apne list hai jisme cooperatives aati hai, and it is a time that we should give more autonomy to the states with regards to the functioning of the cooperative sectors, right. So this is what has been talked about, the incorporation regulations of the cooperative society and the pivotal role of the state in regulating them, right. Now moving to the MCQ questions of the day, before I proceed with the question, just to tell you the answers of your study questions. So for the first question, the correct option is B. For the second question, the correct option is C. Now the question of the day, Technology and Innovation Report 2021 is released by United Nations Conference on Trade Development. Economics Intelligence Unit, World Economic Forum, Global Entrepreneurial and Development Institute. So if you know the correct answer, do let me know in the comment section down below. Second question, the Food Waste Index Report 2021 is released by United Nations Environment Programme, International Food Policy Research Institute, Work Free Foundations, New Economic Foundations. Right? So again, these index are very important. They tend to be asked in the prelims examination. So you have to be, you have to do a rote learning where you must know that which reports and indices are released by which of the organizations, right? So this was all about the daily news and editorial analysis followed by the MCQ questions. If you have any other concern, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much for listening.